A poem. It's not a poem, but it is. I'm going to read something aloud. And I'm going to point at you, Kaywood, when that's time. Okay. This is called An Invocation for Beginnings, and it was written by an artist and performer named Zay Frank almost exactly 11 years ago this week. He was an extremely online video guy before anyone ever did that. Wonderful artist and creator, and I was a huge subscriber and a beautiful human being, and he disappeared for a really long time, and we were really upset. And then when he came back, and he was very scared. He was really worried about coming back because it had been a long time. And this is my first time up here, I think, in about 4 years or 3 years, but in the before four times, and I hadn't done it a lot of times. So this works for me. Okay, so I'm reading this for him. I'm scared. I'm scared that my abilities are gone. I'm scared that I'm gonna fuck this up, and I'm scared of you. I don't want to start, but I will. This is an invocation for anyone who hasn't begun, who's stuck in a terrible place between 0 and 1, Jeremy. Let me realize that my past failures at follow-through are no indication of my future performance. They're just healthy little fires that are going to warm up my ass. If my fuck it, let's do it is strong, let me keep him in a velvet box until I really, really need him. If my fuck it, let's do it is weak, let me feed him oranges and not let him gorge himself on ego and arrogance. Let me not hit up my Facebook like it's a crack pipe. Keep the browser closed. If I catch myself wearing a tutu, too fat, too late, too old, let me shake it off like a donkey would, shake off something it doesn't like. And when I get that feeling in my stomach, you know the feeling, when all of a sudden you get this ball of energy and it shoots down into your legs and up in your arms and tells you to get up and stand up and go to the refrigerator and get a cheese sandwich, that is my cheese monster talking, and my cheese monster will never be satisfied by cheddar, only the cheese of accomplishment. Let me think about all the people who I care about the most and how when they fail or disappoint me, I still love them. I still give them chances and I still see the best in them. And let me extend that generosity to myself. Let me find and use metaphors to help me understand the world around me and give me the strength to get rid of them when it's apparent they no longer work. Let me thank the parts of me that don't understand or are outside of my rational control, like my creativity and my courage. And let me remember that my courage is a wild dog. It won't just come when I call it. I have to chase it down and hold on as tight as I can. Let me not be so vain to think that I'm the sole author of my victories and a victim of my defeats. Let me remember that the unintended meaning that people project onto me, what I do is neither my fault nor something I can take credit for. Perfectionism may look good in his shiny shoes, but he's a little bit of an asshole and no one invites him to their pool parties. Let me remember that the impact of criticism is not often the intent of the critic, but when the intent is evil, that's when the block button is for. When I eat my critique, let me be able to separate the good advice from the bitter herbs. There are a few people who won't be disarmed by a genuine smile. There are a big impact a few can be worth more than a small impact on many. Let me not think of my work only as a stepping stone to something else, and if it is, let me become fascinated with the shape of that stone. Let me take the idea that has gotten me this far and put it to bed. What I'm about to do will not be that, but it will be something. There's no need to sharpen my pencils anymore. My pencils are sharp enough. Even the dull ones will make a mark. Warts and all, let's start this shit up.